Something really weird happened during E3. You know, obviously Hogwarts Legacy was not there, but at the wrap-up video of the Xbox event on Sunday, they showed a second, 1 second from Hogwarts Legacy's trailer. Hogwarts! And then they showed it again in the wrap-up video of the whole E3 after the awards show. There was Hogwarts Legacy again. Why was it there? So it makes me want to think that Hogwarts Legacy was supposed to be at E3, but for some reason, it got pulled off. Hi folks, how's it going? I'm Ben Snow and welcome to my channel. And in this video, we're going to discuss all the reasons why Hogwarts Legacy wasn't at E3. Why was it pulled off? And also, we're going to take a look at the upcoming events where Hogwarts Legacy has a chance of showing up. Let's get the frick started. E3 went great. There were great announcements. There were good stuff. I love Breath of the Wild. Forza Horizon looked awesome. But where's the freaking Hogwarts Legacy? Where was it? And I was really hopeful about the E3. I thought this would be it. And, you know, and when they, on Sunday, when they showed that tiny little snippet, I got reassured. I thought they're gonna show it, like, in a little bit, or like, I don't know. I thought it was gonna happen. But it never did. But what does this mean? Well, first, it seems like Warner Brothers barely attended E3. Like, they did have the showcase of Back 4 Blood, but that's it. Where's Gotham Knights? Where's Suicide Squad? Lego Star Wars? And freaking Hogwarts Legacy? Like, well, maybe they're planning to make their own event somewhere in August? Now, who knows? Maybe they're gonna follow the steps of Sony. And they're gonna have their own showcase. But the other reason could be that maybe Hogwarts Legacy is too deep into the production and they don't have anything to show yet. Maybe like they were preparing for the showcase, but then it just didn't happen. Something failed, something didn't work. They looked at the gameplay trailer that they recorded and it was and they decided, okay, no, we gotta pull it out. We gotta pull out other the thing. Because you know, all those videos, all those wrap-up videos, all the interviews, everything's pre-recorded way ahead of the actual event. And that's why we usually get the leaks. And of course, there is some live element to it. There are the hosts, you know, but there's so much of it is pre-recorded. And that's why I think something must have happened, because they showed those two snippets on two different occasions. Like, why would they do it? It wasn't there. Why would you show a snippet of a trailer that wasn't at E3? There was no word about Hogwarts Legacy whatsoever. Maybe they simply didn't want to compete with Xbox and Nintendo events. Like, it could be that the developers looked at the lineup of the games and they realized it would be really hard to compete with the announcements. And instead, they would rather have a more focused event so the game gets a full attention. Because, I mean, it's kind of true. I feel like that's part of the reason why Sony is not at E3. Because all those titles that are announced, they kind of get desaturated, you know, because of other announcements. Because, you know, a lot of games are announced at the same time and all the fans kind of give half attention to everyone. You know, it kind of gets blurry. In the way. I mean, I love the E3. It's the celebration of gaming. It's awesome, but it is understandable if they would rather have, you know, their own dedicated event. And you know, if there's a title that stands out, that's gonna be it. That's gonna be the headline for the whole month, you know, or the whole week. That's gonna be the title. It's gonna be the game of the event. It's a thought, but I'm sure that's part of the reason. Now, the question is, when is the next chance for Hogwarts Legacy to reveal the new content? Possibly a new gameplay trailer. For now, the only confirmed sort of big event is the EA Play that is going to happen on July 22nd. But honestly, I don't think it's gonna be there. I mean, it's possible, but I for some reason, no. I don't think it's gonna, it's just why? Not why, it's just, I don't know. I think looking at that event in July, it doesn't look that big to me. And I think the most likely place for Hogwarts Legacy to have a showcase is the PlayStation event, which hasn't been announced yet, but it will. Once this whole E3 boils down they will announce their own event, and everyone will start waiting for that. And I'm starting to think that Hogwarts Legacy may actually have some sort of exclusivity with Sony. And that's what I actually mentioned in my previous video when I was talking about the chances of Hogwarts Legacy being at E3. And I said that one of the reasons why Hogwarts Legacy may not be at E3 is because Sony is not at E3. Like, we know Hogwarts Legacy is not PlayStation exclusive, but it kind of looks like that it sort of is. Simply because the trailer was revealed at Sony event, and on Hogwarts Legacy's official website, they've mentioned that they are going to take a full advantage of the adaptive triggers of the new PS5 controllers. So because of that, I think Hogwarts Legacy may have some sort of partial non-verbal exclusivity with PlayStation. Due to their contract, you know, they're not bound to them, but they, any event, any reveal, any announcements will have to come at a PlayStation event. And it does make sense. And it's starting to look like that. I mean, for Hogwarts Legacy, for a big title like that, for such an anticipated game, to me, it was either E3 or the PlayStation event. Either or. I mean, for now, it is what it is. We'll just have to wait and see. But again, this sucks. It sucks that Hogwarts Legacy is not, we didn't see anything, but whatever, we will. We will eventually. But yeah, let me know in the comments if you were actually like devastated with Hogwarts Legacy not being at E3. Cause I was really hoping for it. And yeah, I'm disappointed. At the end of the day, it was a cool event. It was great. There were great games, you know. I was really surprised with the Avatar game. Forza Horizon looked amazing. I'm not into racing games, but that game looked awesome. And I would actually might check it out. And of course, Zelda. I feel like that's the biggest one. But anyways, guys, thank you for watching. Make sure you hit the like if you like this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. And hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on my future videos. Thank you. Have a good one.